Welcome to the pregame.com podcast. This is an audio and video podcast, and this is for the week of September 16th. This is segment 2 of 4, and in segment 2 and 3, we look at big game previews. And I'm your host, RJ Bell, and this week we're looking at, in college, Virginia Tech, Nebraska. I'm joined by Marco D'Angelo, 30 years in the business, Vegas runner, a genuine professional batter. Vegas runner, tell us about this game.
Very interesting game, because you have two different outlooks on it, the pollsters and the odds makers. The odds maker tells you
that... And
there's
always an opportunity, I think, when even though the public is getting more savvy, when they look at something like a few weeks ago, the Alabama game against, I'm having a mental block.
Virginia Tech.
It was Virginia Tech. Okay, thank you. It was a situation where they were ranked almost the same in the AP, I think 5 and 7, but Alabama was a touchdown favorite. Uh-huh. So this week we got something similar.
Exactly. And the line opened 2.5, 3, anywhere around there, with Virginia Tech being the favorite at home. It's now been bet up to 5. The interesting part is this was one of them listed games that they have in the summer, key games that you could bet on months in advance.
All right. And when the line was?
7. Virginia Tech -7.
Okay, so it opened up at 7 way back when. It was bet all the way down to the point where when everyone opened it up the week before, because only certain books offer those key games.
Correct.
Months in advance, they opened it up 2.5.
And small limits, too.
And smaller limits. When they opened it up for the week's action, they opened it up at 2.5. So clearly there was a ton of money on Nebraska throughout those few months before it just opened up.
Right, again. Right. And they sent it back out at much lower, the 2.5, 3, and it got bet up right away, up to 5 now we're looking at.
Okay, now how much? I wonder how much of that is Midland action, where these wise guys got down to +7 or +6,
and laid the 2.5, 3,
and now
sure.
They're laying the 2.5.
Sure.
Or 3.
I think plenty of it is, and I'm interested to see where this line finally ends up. Will it get to like 6 or 7, where they thought it should be when this whole mess started during the spring or summer?
So that's an interesting thing, and Marco, let's get your thoughts. Is I'm a big believer. In fact, I don't even think it's debatable, that the early betting action is all wise guy action, because a guy that's betting a game Sunday night for next Saturday is a pretty sharp
Sure. Bettor.
So 99% of the time. So typically I say, hey, show me that move the first day or two, and that's the wise guy move. But if the game was available to be bet somewhere else earlier, then it might not always be a true move that early week action on these marquee games, but it may be something where they're middling from a movement that happened with something, a bet they made months ago.
Mm-hmm.
I think we got to be more careful now that these marquee games are put up so far ahead of time to look at that earliest move as a pure bet.
I agree with what you're saying in principle. There's a couple instances that I disagree with, the early money being the wise guy money only. When it's a big game that's going to be on TV, I think people do get opinions right away. Some of the people will bet the games. Now, if this is a game that's, you know, two smaller schools and you see a move early, that's definitely wise guy money. But if it's going to be a marquee game that's going to be popular, these are two ranked teams, the public generally has an opinion right away. And the way I'm reading this game is, when I looked at it, I thought the line was low early, because Nebraska...
It's 2.5 or 3.
Yep. Nebraska is a team that, you know, was a powerhouse 15, 20 years ago. I mean, they've been on the downslide the last 5, 6 years. They're trying to build the program back up now, and this is a program that's on its way back. They won 2 big games, blowouts, but they were against nobody. I think last week was Arkansas State. Virginia Tech has been a perennial powerhouse, been a key in the ACC, been a top 10.
All right, so the Virginia Tech just had, as we talked about, a big game against Alabama. How do you think they came away? And again, the public remembers what they see recently. How do you think they came away in the eyes of the public?
Well, the fact that they played the game, the final score looks as if they played Alabama very tough. I mean, they only lost by 10, and Alabama had to score late to secure that 10-point win.
And the cover.
The cover. But the situation is, if you break the game down, they did not play Alabama well. They gave up 500 yards of offense to an Alabama team that was starting, you know, a rookie quarterback. You know, they graduated their quarterback last year, was a new quarterback, and they still put up 500 yards. I think the public likes Virginia Tech in this game at that small number. I think Vegas wanted you to take Virginia Tech. I like Nebraska in the game. I think Nebraska is an unknown commodity yet. They've played two weak teams, so you don't know if they're for real or not. But what I saw the line come out at, to me, tells me they are for real, and I'll be looking at Nebraska side in the game.
What I think we need to add is the difference in the rankings, too. I mean, you got the odds makers saying Nebraska's the higher-ranked team. Nebraska's 13, and Virginia Tech's 19. The pollsters, the AP, USA Today, are saying the exact opposite, that Virginia Tech's actually 13th best in the country, and Nebraska's 19th. So I think this comes down to who's right and whose perception is more correct. And I think a lot of it goes back to last year they played. These two teams played each other. You look at the final score, it's not indicative of what happened. It ended 35-30. But Nebraska scored 14 of those points in the final 2 minutes of the game. So Virginia Tech totally dominated them at Nebraska last year.
Which adds to my point that now they're playing at home. They beat them out there, and they came out with a number where Virginia Tech just basically had to win the game today.
What do you think, RJ, if the odds maker saying his line, Nebraska's 3 points better than Virginia Tech?
All right, so
this should have came out of pick 'em, correct?
All right, so and I think that's an interesting point is, and let's just be very clear, is if you look at the power rankings that the odds makers put out, they're saying Nebraska is 3 points better.
Correct.
Which, if Virginia Tech at home should be a 3-point favorite if the teams are even, that means the game should have came out right around a pick. Well, the game came out at 2.5. So it didn't come out too far from the lines maker saying, we believe that Nebraska is a slightly better team. But what's happened here is the public has said, hey, we disagree with you. We actually tend to agree with the polls more that this Virginia Tech team is better. And they bet this thing, like you said, up to 5. So it's not a situation where it's the poll. You know, in the Alabama game against Virginia Tech, we had the polls versus the betting market. The odds makers in the betting market agreed. It was about a touchdown favor for Alabama. Now we have a situation where the odds makers disagree with both the polls and the betting public, which is a situation where and just to finish the point quickly, is if you want to believe in the odds makers, here's a chance where they're saying that the game should almost be a pick 'em,
and you're getting almost
and you're getting 5 points.
Yeah.
So it's either it's really a battle now. The public and the odds makers are off by about 5 points.
And that's what it's going to come down to. I think if you're going to bet this game, you got to pick a side.
To me, there's already a precedent set here. And you started to say it, but you didn't hit it. The Alabama-Virginia Tech game.
Please,
Mario.
You shook it out of him.
Make my point.
I'm going to. Well, it is.
Slap it out of him.
The first game where there was a difference between the polls and the lines, you had Alabama was ranked 5th, I think.
Yeah, they're right there.
And they made it a touchdown.
Mm-hmm.
These two teams, there's a wider gap in the rankings on the polls, and they're down at the bottom end of the scale, yet they're only making it 3. That's why I liked Alabama in the first game, because they had two teams that were so good and so closely ranked, and they had it the full touchdown. They were begging you to take Virginia Tech in that game. Here, they're begging you to take Virginia Tech again, only they're taking it as the favorite. To me, this is how I make a living, is these type of games. I think Nebraska's the side.
Nebraska goes 3-0?
I like Nebraska.
So when you say you make a living, is you like to try to interpret the situations where Vegas is trying to get you to play a certain way.
Absolutely.
And you want to go the other way. Now, if their effort was to try to get you to play Virginia Tech, they're doing a pretty good job, because early in the week, it's gone, like you said, from 2.5 to 5.
Right.
Exactly.
My confusion is how much they have absolutely no confidence in their numbers, obviously, the odds maker. Because like we said, this was one of them key games that was put out months ago, and he put it out at 7. So now all of a sudden there's that big of an adjustment.
Well, remember now, let's be
and
fair.
And it's smaller limits.
And let's be fair, is the odds that we're referring to saying they're even teams have now had a couple games of view these
to
teams.
To see how they are, correct.
I think that's
a little harsh on them.
No, but this really is a situation, ultimately, where it's odds makers. If you agree with them, you take Nebraska. If you agree with the public in the polls, you're taking Virginia Tech. It's really that simple.
Couldn't have put it better.
Segment 2, segment 3 is coming right up. We have another big game preview. You can see all the segments at pregame.tv.